गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, हियर वी स्टार्ट चैप्टर टू ऑफ सिविक्स ऑफ क्लास सेवेंथ, दैट इज पिलर्स ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी. वी हैव रीड दैट द डेमोक्रेसी इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी द बेस्ट फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट, बट वॉट आर द फैक्टर्स दैट मेक इट सुपीरियर टू ऑल अदर फॉर्म्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट्स. लेट अस हैव अ लुक एट सम ऑफ इट्स स्पेशल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स एंड ट्राई टू एसर्टेन द रीजन. Enlightened citizen. A true democracy stands for the expression of the will of the people. It is the very base of the democratic form of government. People are the supreme authority in a true democracy, and all changes are brought about by their collective will and not by the use of force. Political awareness. Political awareness of the people is one of the most important aspects of a true democratic country. The citizen should have sufficient knowledge and they should have political awareness so that they can make the right choice by taking the right decision at the appropriate time. It does not mean that they should be highly educated or have university degrees, but they should be conscious enough to make judicial decision. Only a politically enlightened citizen can judge the performance of the government and make the right choice of their representatives by weighing up their merits and demerits. Sensible or wise leadership. It is not possible for all citizens of a vast country like ours to take direct part in the administration of the country. Therefore, they elect their representatives to represent them in the legislature. For this purpose, elections are held after a certain period. Elections are an important part of democracy. Different political parties take part in these elections by fielding their candidates. The leaders of various political parties held several public meetings as part of their election campaign. They discuss various issues and problems and try to apprise the voters of their plans and programs for these issues and problems. If voted the power, such meetings help people to make up their mind and take a firm decision about whom to vote for. After the elections are over, the party having the largest number of elected representatives emerges victorious and are invited to form the government. In case none of the parties gets absolute majority, a coalition government is formed. Thus, we see that if the voters are politically aware and conscious of their duties and responsibilities, they elect only those leaders as their representatives who are efficient, devoted, and committed. The real progress of the country depends on the safe hands and such leaders. Sound public opinion. A true democratic government is formed and run by the people through their elected representatives. As such, public opinion as a decision making plays a vital role in a democracy. In a true democracy, government people have the right to choose their representatives according to their conscience. They are entitled to express their opinion by casting votes during an election. No democratic government can ignore public opinion. If ever they ignore it or try to suppress public opinion, people can oust them in the very next election. But what is meant by public opinion? We can describe it as the wishes of the people on any issue or problem. Enlightened citizens always have their own views and opinion on various public issues and problems. Though their opinions may differ, but the views of the majority are taken as the public opinion. Sometimes even a minority may express an opinion which may be in the interest of the entire community. Thus, wishes of the people on the public issues and problems are called public opinion. Social and economic equality. The foundation of the democracy is based on the principles of equality and human dignity. Therefore, a true democratic society should be free from all kinds of bias and prejudice. There should not be any discrepancy of the basis of caste, religion, faith, gender or language, all sections of the society should equally contribute to the development and prosperity of the country. The rule of law is an essential element of democracy. Every citizen is equal before the law. A true democracy should always also have a free and fearless, which anyone can approach if he she feels that justice has been denied to him her. A society can truly be called democratic only if all its members get due respect and dignity as human beings. Thus, social and economic equality are essential conditions for the successful working of democracy. Thank you.